I know that our rules, procedure in aid of legislation includes supplementarily the use of the rules of court. Under the rules of court, Your Honor, which are the rules being used in the courts of law, hypothetical questions are not allowed to be asked. Are we supposed to insist on asking hypothetical questions?
Could you please be specific, Congressman Margoleta?
It's very specific, Mr. Chair. The witness is being asked hypothetical questions. This is allowed in the courts of law. If you're using the rules of court supplementarily, what is the purpose of asking hypothetical questions?
Hindi po tayo makakagawa ng mga batas, hindi natin maaaral yung pwedeng maging mga batas kung hindi natin pag-uusapan yung mga posibleng scenarios kahit hindi pa nangyayari, Mr. Chair. We can't have good laws kung hindi natin pag-uusapan paano yan pwedeng ipatupad, paano yan pwedeng maabuso, which means yung nagiging line of questioning na ating colleagues are essential to the conduct of our proceedings sa committee. Ilang, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Mr. Chair, this is the problem of non-lawyers. They insist on something that should not be done.
Noted, Congressman Margoleta.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Madam Vice President.
Can I answer as head of agency of the Office of the Vice President? Can I answer as head of agency of the Office of the Vice President as well?
With respect to the?
To the comment manifestation of Congressman Margoleta, sir.
No, you are not allowed.
Of 2022. At kung may sinasabi po kayong accomplishment report na hindi final, will you be generous enough to share it with us?
Wala po akong dala ngayon, ma'am.
Yes, but for the next hearing, will you be willing to submit it to the committee?
Yes po.
Yes. Okay. Ms. Acosta, we have here the final, I suppose, because this was provided by the COA, accomplishment report for the last quarter of 2022. Ang sabi niyo po, sa amount lang kayo nagkakaiba.
Yes po.
Can you enlighten us? Bakit po nagkakaroon ng disparity sa amount?
Kasi po, example po yung payment of rewards, ma'am. Ang nilagay, hindi ako makakita.
Secretariat, can we provide instead a copy? You were pertaining to payment of reward. Ang nakalagay po dyan is 10 million.
Yes, ma'am.
Ano po bang nakalagay doon sa hindi final?
Ang nilagay lang po niya doon is 8 million po.
Okay. How about the purchase of information?
So far, ito lang po ang aking maalala, ma'am. Ma-confirm ko sa iyo na 1,000 lang po ang proposed object of expenditure na binigay sa akin ni Sir La Chica.
Ms. Acosta, with your object of expenditure, would you confirm with me na kung anong items ang nakasulat sa object of expenditure, yun din po ang nakasulat dito sa accomplishment report. The only difference is with respect to the amount. Tama ho ba?
Tama po.
Tama. At ang inyo pong sinusunod ay yung object of expenditure na binibigay sa inyo ni Colonel La Chica. Tama din po?
For releasing po.
For releasing?
Opo.
But nevertheless, who prepared the object of expenditure?
Si Sir La Chica po, ma'am.
Sir La Chica. Kung si Sir La Chica po ang gumagawa ng object of expenditure at yun po ang sinusundan nyo sa pagre-release ng confidential fund, tama po bang sabihin na si Colonel La Chica ang nasusunod sa preparation ng accomplishment report?
Yes po. Pag binigay niya sa akin ang final na accomplishment report po niya, ma'am, after po, maubos na ang pera at na-implement na niya lahat ng maayos ang activities.
I will remind you of your answer, Ms. Acosta. Ang sabi niyo po, si Colonel Lachica ang nasusunod sa preparation and accomplishment report. Tama po?
Yes po, ma'am.
Okay. I wish to direct your attention to the left bottom portion of this accomplishment report. It says, prepared by Special Disbursing Officer Gina F. Acosta.
Yes po.
Is this not contradictory to what you said na ang nasusunod ay si Colonel Lachica?
Pag final ko nito, ma'am, gibase ko po to sa binigay ni Sir Lachica na final accomplishment report. So kinokopya ko lang po.
Ibig sabihin, kayo po ay tagagawa lamang ni Colonel Lachica?
Hindi naman po.
So ano pong ibig sabihin nyo na ang sinusundan nyo ay kung anong gustong ipalagay dito sa accomplishment report, which is based on the object of expenditures provided by Colonel Lachica?
Ang nilagay po niya sa object of expenditures po, ma'am, ay in connection na po sa aming prepare ng financial and physical plan po. Kasi kasama ko po siya paggawa ng financial and physical plan.
Financial and physical plan. Sino po bang gumagawa ng financial and physical plan?
Ang nagdadrap po, ang nagprepare ako po at si Sir Lachica.
Okay. Ano po ba ang trabaho ni Colonel Lachica? Malapit na po akong malito. Malapit ko na pong isipin ang disbursing officer ay si Colonel Lachica.
Hindi po.
What is the designation of Colonel Lachica, please?
Siya po ang aming security officer.
And a security officer, ano ho bang trabaho ni Colonel Lachica? Is it her job to prepare the financial plan?
Hindi po.
Is it her job to prepare the accomplishment report?
In the financial po, siya po ang magbibigay sa akin ng information or guide kung ano po ang magiging confidential activities po in relation sa confidential funds po na gagamitin.
I hope you realize, Ms. Acosta, that you are the special disbursing officer.
Yes po, ma'am. Alam ko po.
And part of your job is to prepare the financial plan.
Yes
po. As a matter of fact, the financial plan does not bear at all the signature or the name of Colonel Lachica.
Yes po, pero sa kanya po ako humihingi ng inputs or information in, with regards to the implementation of all the projects included under confidential funds po.
If you're asking for the possible program, subject of expenditure, is it correct to say that you are soliciting some information only and not necessarily the one working with you in the preparation of financial plan? Magkaiba po yun.
Ang hinihingi po, hinihingi ko po sa kanya, ma'am, is ano po, mga inputs po or guidance in preparation for the financial plan, especially related po sa confidential activities po.
Ms. Acosta, do you understand your job as a special disbursing officer?
Yes, ma'am.
This is very significant job.
Yes, ma'am.
Because it entails so much trust and confidence.
Yes, po.
Because you are the one in charge of taking custody of the huge amount of money. Tama?
Yes, ma'am.
As a matter of fact, to ensure the fidelity of this money, nire-require pa kayo ng fidelity fund, bond. Tama po ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Then why do you keep on pointing to Colonel Lachica?
Kasi siya po ang may alam kung i-implement na po yung mga project under confidential plan funds.
Who will be responsible in case this money is misappropriated? Who will be responsible in case this money is lost? Who will be responsible in case this money went to the wrong person? Sino po ba ang magiging responsable?
Ako po.
Because you are the special disbursing officer and not Colonel Lachica.
Yes po.
Let's go back to the question. 125 million po yun. You were saying ang object of expenditure is similar to the accomplishment report. The only difference is the amount.
Yes, ma'am.
Enlighten us. Ano ang laman ng object expenditure totaling to 125 million, reason why you fully turned over the entire amount?
Ang laman po ng binigay niya sa akin ng object of expenditures ay yun pong pamaraan kung ano ang ginagawa niya.
Can we please be specific? We're talking of huge amount of money, Ms. Acosta. This is 125 million. Of course, you realize the significance of this amount. And being the special disbursing officer, hindi mo ito basta ita-turn over kung hindi mo nakikita na well-tallied yung object of expenditure that you are referring to. Tama ba?
Yes, ma'am. Pero may information na po ako na pag natanggap ko ang pera, ibigay ko po sa security officer namin.
Even without the object of expenditure?
Meron po.
Okay, let's go back to your object of expenditure. Kasi ako, Ms. Acosta, if I am the custodian of 125 million and I was directed to turn over this to a certain person, I will be very careful to make sure that whatever's in the list tally to the entire amount of 125 million. Now tell us, ano ang laman ng object of expenditure?
Ang laman po ng object of expenditures ay yun pong mga expected expenses sa pagpatupad po ng confidential activities.
I know. Can you please state the item? Kanina po, ang sabi nyo, purchase of information, payment of reward. Ituloy nyo po yun. You even said that there's a payment of reward. Hindi nasunod yung 10 million. So magkano po ang nasunod?
Ito na po akong placement report na final, ma'am. Yung giatas ko po sa liquidation report.
Okay. So, are you changing your answer now? Kasi kanina po ang sabi nyo, object expenditure is not yet final. Accomplishment report is final.
Yes po. Yes po.
So, are you referring to two different documents, object expenditure and accomplishment report?
Yes po, yan po ang gusto kong iparating po.
And you were saying, ito na nga po yun. Ano bang ibig sabihin when you said, ito na nga po yun? What do you mean by that?
Ang binigay po sa akin ni Sir La Chica, hindi po ganito ang forma, ma'am. Simple lang po, ma'am.
Okay.
Para basis po ng aking release ng pera para sa kanya,
ma'am. Let me go back to your answer a while ago. Ang sabi niyo po kanina, Ms. Acosta, parehas ang items, the only difference is the amount.
Opo, pero hindi po ganito, ma'am. Simple lang po, ma'am.
Yes, enlighten us. Magkano ang nakalagay sa purchase of information?
Less than 14 million po, ma'am.
Less than?
Opo.
Can't you remember the amount?
12 million po.
12 million. Payment of reward.
Ito po yung 8 million, ma'am.
8 million. Rentals.
Rentals of safe houses. Ito po ang malaki, ma'am.
How much?
Ito na po ang amount na nabigay niya sa akin doon sa kanyang...
How much, Ms. Acosta?
16 million po.
16?
Opo.
Purchase of supplies?
Malaki po ito, ma'am. Nagiging 37 po.
37. Payment of incentives? No. Provision of medical and food aid?
Hindi ko na ito maalala, ma'am. I'm sorry po, ma'am.
Basta hindi mo maalala.
Basta yung tinali.
Payment of incentive?
11 po.
11. Would you know whether this amounts would total to 125 million exactly?
Yes, ma'am. Gitotal ko po yun, ma'am. 120 million po.
You were able to check if the items and the amounts provided in the object of expenditure total to 125 million. You checked that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Tanong, Ms. Acosta. What gave you the confidence? Ano ang nagbigay sa inyo ng lakas ng loob na ibigay ang buong 125 million kay Colonel Lachica, considering that he is not the accountable officer, because it is you who is the accountable officer.
May approval po kay Ma'am Inday Sara.
And without the approval of the Vice President, will you give that to Colonel Lachica?
Hindi po.
Do you know Colonel Lachica?
Yes po, kasi siya po ang aming ground commander.
How long have you known Colonel Lachica?
Yung na-employ po ako after 3 months, yung na-employ po ako sa OBP, ma'am.
How long have you known? Since 2022?
Yes po, ma'am.
Do you trust Colonel Lachica?
I trust Lachica. I trust Sir Lachica kasi ginatrust po siya ng aking head of office na si Ma'am Inday Sara.
In other words, the only reason why you are giving your trust to Colonel Lachica is because of the instruction of the Vice President.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Without the instruction of the Vice President, you will never give the entire amount of 125 million to Colonel Lachica.
Yes, ma'am.
And do you realize also, Ms. Acosta, that as disbursing officer, there is a rule under PD 1445, bawal i-transfer ang disbursement sa ibang tao.
Pero ang boss ko po kasi ay si Ma'am.
Please answer the question, ma'am.
Yes.
Under PD 1445, unauthorized transfer of disbursement is prohibited. Are you aware of that?
Yes, ma'am.
And what you did is an unauthorized transfer. Tama po?
Yes, po, ma'am. Pero may...
In other words, you are liable for the unauthorized transfer of that money which is due for your disbursement. Tama po?
Tama po, ma'am. Pero...
Are you aware also that kung ito pong perang ito ay mapupunta sa mga hindi matitino na government officials at gagamitin for purpose other than its confidential purpose, you can be held liable for malversation of public funds by negligence.
Yes, alam ko po, ma'am. Pero nanaig po ang aking belief na may trust po ako kay Lachica dahil po authorized po siya ni Ma'am Sara Duterte.
And are you aware also that what Colonel Lachica did is he usurped your authority as special disbursing officer? Ang ginawa po ni Colonel Lachica ay pinakialaman na yung trabaho na dapat ay sa inyo. We call that usurpation of authority.
Kasi po wala po akong alam kung paano po i-implement ang mga confidential activities po, ma'am. Bakit si Sir Lachica lang po ang may alam.
Sandali po, bakit po wala kayong alam? You are the special disbursing officer. You prepare the financial plan. You are a signatory in the disbursement. You prepare the liquidation. You certify. You prepare the accomplishment report. Bakit wala po kayong alam?
Wala po akong alam sa pag-implement po ng confidential activities po. Dahil po, hindi ko po yan in line sa aking pinag-aralan, ma'am.
But as the special disbursing officer, of course you realize you have the function of disbursing the fund.
Yes po, pero may utos po sa akin na ibigay po kay Colonel Lachica kasi siya po ang expert, siya po ang may kaalaman kung paano po i-achieve ang mga confidential activities na safely and hindi po magulo.
Would you know, Ms. Acosta, kung saan po dinala ni Colonel Lachica yung 125 million?
Di ko po na po alam, ma'am, kasi sa kanya na po yun discretion kung...
Hindi po niya discretion yun, ma'am.
Kaya sa kanya na po yung
please
trabaho.
Please understand, kayo po ang special disbursing officer. You're supposed to be the person doing the payment of this amount to various payees. Hindi po ito discretion ni Colonel Lachica, ma'am. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Ano nga po ulit trabaho ni Colonel Lachica?
Siya po ang...
Head?
Head ng aming BPSPG at siya po ang inatasan as security officer po ng Office of the Vice President.
And of course, you will agree with me, iba po ang trabaho ng security officer sa trabaho ng special disbursing officer. Tama po ba? As a matter of fact, kaya po kayo'y banded. Kaya po kayo nire-require ng Fidelity Fund is to take care of these public funds. Si Colonel Lachica po ba? Covered po ba siya ng Fidelity Fund?
Hindi po, ma'am.
I don't think so because it's not part of his job to disburse public funds.
Pero siya po ang may alam, ma'am, lalo na pag-implement sa mga confidential activities po, ma'am. Just like surveillance and monitoring po. Kung okay po ba dyan, itayo, example, yung satellite office.
Even when he is aware of the implementation of the surveillance activities, you, as a special disbursing officer, should be the one actually paying all the recipients. Do you understand, Ms. Acosta?
I understand po, ma'am.
Then why did you give all the money to Colonel Lachica?
Because po may utos po si Ma'am Inday Sara na sa kanya ko po i-release. Kasi siya po ang nakakaalam kung paano po i-implement ang mga programs and activities in line po sa confidential fund. Okay. Siya po ang mag-survey, surveillance and monitoring po. Sa kanya po yun, wala po akong alam.
Ms. Acosta, I hope you realize that it is incumbent upon you as the special disbursing officer to know all the recipients of the entire 125 million. And it is totally wrong to say na wala kayong alam. Because in the first place, trabaho nyo po to disburse these funds to the various number of recipients. Let us proceed to liquidation report. Secretariat, kindly flash the liquidation report. What is the purpose, Ms. Acosta, of the liquidation report?
To liquidate the funds granted on confidential funds po. Ililiquidate po.
Ililiquidate, and by liquidate, we need to gather proof that indeed the entire amount was utilized for the intended purpose. Tama po ba?
Tama po.
What is your participation in this liquidation report?
Yung binigay na po sa akin ni Sir Lachica ang acknowledgement.
Ms. Acosta, please be directed to the left bottom part of the liquidation report.
Correctness of the above data po, ma'am.
Do you understand what that means?
Yes po, ma'am.
Ano pong ibig sabihin nun?
Na ang pundo po ay nagamit ng maayos sa pamagitan po ng pagkuha ng mga acknowledgement receipt po na galing po kay Sir Lachica.
You mentioned about acknowledgement receipts. Pag-usapan po natin yan. As a special disbursing officer, part of your job is to certify the correctness of the above data, and that includes the acknowledgement receipts that you mentioned. You agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Based on examination, Ms. Acosta, mayroong 700 na acknowledgement receipts. My signature, pero walang printed name. In other words, we could not hold anyone accountable for the given amounts. What can you say about that? 700 mahigit na acknowledgement receipts, my signature, pero walang printed name, so you cannot tell who the recipient really is. Do you think, given that situation, you certified the correctness of the data?
Kasi
yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
And you believe that that is correct? Yes. Hindi mo alam kung sino ang recipient?
Kasi yan po ang binigay sa akin ni Sir La Chica, ma'am.
Again, please be directed by the certification at the bottom right of this document. Gina Acosta, certifying to the correctness of the above data. And that data includes the acknowledgement receipts. How did you certify correct the 700 plus acknowledgement receipts which bear unreadable signatures and does not bear the printed name of the recipients? Tama po ba yun?
Sa paningin ko, ma'am, ang maka-answer po ng maayos ay si Sir La Chica po, ma'am.
Sa paningin niyo po bilang special disbursing officer, tama po ba na ang acknowledgement receipt ay wala kang pagkitaan ng pangalan? Tama po ba yun?
Kasi po ang alam ko
please
po...
Please answer the question, Ms. Acosta. I believe that the question is answerable by yes or no only. Kayo po ang special disbursing officer and you said from this liquidation report, I'm certifying to the correctness of the above data. 700 plus acknowledgement receipts with signature, unreadable, and without printed name. Tama po ba na i-certify na tama yung 700 mahigit na acknowledgement receipts na yon? Tama po o mali?
Tama po, ma'am.
Tama?
Yes po, ma'am.
Kahit wala pong pangalan?
Kasi po, ang makasagot po niyan ng maayos, ma'am, pwede po si Sir La Chica.
Okay, let's do this by way of hypothetical question. Kayo po ang accountable disbursing officer. Ibig sabihin, kayo po ang may pananagutan sakaling mawala, may mangyaring hindi tama, dito po sa 125 million. I hope you anchor your answer on the fact na kayo po ang mananagot doon sa 125 million as a special disbursing officer. Tama po ba nag-release kayong pera? Tapos yung acknowledgement receipt, walang pangalan ng recipient. Tama po o mali? Kung kayo po ang mismong magre-release ng pera, kayo po ba'y papayag na walang printed name ang acknowledgement receipt?
Pwede po, ma'am, itanong po kay Sir La Chica po.
No, the question, Ms. Acosta, is hypothetical, no? Kung sakali lang pong kayo mismo ang nagbigay dun sa 700 na tao yon, kayo po ang accountable disbursing officer, papayag po ba kayo na yung 700 na yon tatanggap lang ng tatanggap ng pera tapos ni hindi nyo alam kung anong mga pangalan nila? Yun po ba ay tama o mali? You said already that it was Colonel La Chica who did the disbursement. Naintindihan ko na po yun.
Opo, ma'am.
Pero ang sitwasyon po natin ngayon, let us assume na kayo ang magre-release ng pera. Papayag po ba kayong mag-release ng pera na hindi sinusulat yung printed name ng pagbibigyan nyo ng pera?
Siguro po. Nangyari po yun dahil po sa voluminous na transaction, ma'am.
Ms. Acosta, the question is answerable only by tama o mali. We are talking about 700 plus acknowledgement receipts. May signature, walang printed name, walang pagkitaan ng pangalan ng recipients. Kung kayo po ang magre-release nito, papayag po ba kayo na walang printed name ang tumanggap?
Hindi po, pero depende po sa sitwasyon.
You have given your answer already. Ms. Acosta, let's proceed to the next category of acknowledgement receipts. Mayroon naman pong 300 plus. May signature, may printed name, pero hindi naman mabasa yung pregnant name. In other words, wala din pong pagkitaan kung sino ang recipient. Again, on the assumption na kayo po ang magre-release ng perang ito sa recipient, papayag po ba kayong i-release itong perang ito na hindi nyo nakitang nakasulat ang pangalan ng recipient?
Nag-trust po ako kay Council ay kay Sir La Chica, ma'am.
Ms. Acosta, let us answer the question po. I understand na ang sabi niyo po si Colonel La Chica ang nag-release.
Yes po.
On the assumption only, kunyari lang po kayo ang magre-release. Andyan yung recipient. 300 mahigit po to. Papayag po ba kayo na hindi niyo mabasa ang mga tunay na pangalan ng pinagbibigyan nyo ng pera?
Kung ako po ang nagbigay, hindi po ako papayag.
Hindi kayo papayag. Now, let us go to the acknowledgement receipt with the recipient whose name is Mary Grace Piatos. Do we still have that slide, Secretariat? Can we please share it? I wish to believe na nakita nyo na po ito during the previous hearings. Again, hypothetical question ulit. Kung kayo po ba ang magre-release ng pera to a name, Mary Grace Piatos, kayo po ba ay papayag?
Papayag pa ako, ma'am. Meron naman pong Piatos na apelyedo.
Do you know Mary Grace Piatos? Do you know Mary Grace Piatos?
Wala po. Hindi ko po siya kilala, ma'am.
But you said napapayag kayo kasi may apelidong Piatos. San ho ba kayo nakakita na apelidong Piatos?
Meron po sa amin sa Davao, ma'am.
Meron po na apelidong Piatos. I will be interested to know, Ms. Acosta, kung sino po yung mga taga Davao na may apelidong Piatos. But do you honestly believe na meron pong Mary Grace Piatos?
Yes, ma'am. Sa Davao po, meron.
Meron?
Opo.
Bakit po kaya hindi siya lumulutang? I am reminded by the pledge of, I believe, the Young Guns who contributed money to raise 1 million asking Mary Grace Piatos to come out to the open. Bakit po kaya walang lumulutang? If indeed mayroong Mary Grace Piatos sa Davao.
Kasi po, nagbibis lang po ako sa binigay po ni Sir La Chica na mga binalik niya sa akin.
Ms. Acosta, kindly answer the question po. Ang sabi niyo po kanina, mayroong Mary Grace Piatos.
Piatos po ang sinabi ko, ma'am, na apelyedo.
Okay. Nonetheless, kayo po ba'y naniniwalang mayroong Mary Grace Piatos? In the first place, kayo po dapat kaharap nito eh. Dahil kayong special disbursing officer. But you kept on claiming that you handed the entire amount to Colonel La Chica. Kaya hindi nyo alam kung anong nangyari dun sa pera. O ito na po ang consequence. Ipinagtiwala nyo ang disbursement sa hindi naman accountable officer. How will you answer now to that acknowledgement receipt? Paano nyo po ngayon ipapaliwanag yan? Kayo po ang accountable officer and you're bound to explain who is Mary Grace Piatos.
Hindi po talaga ako maka-explain yan, ma'am, kasi hindi po ako ang nagpapipirma po, ang nag-execute po ng acknowledgement na yun, ma'am, si Sir La Chica po.
You said ang nag-execute po ng acknowledgement ay si Sir La Chica. Sino pong pumirma dyan?
Siya lang po ang makakaalam, ma'am.
Si Colonel La Chica lang ang nakakaalam.
Yes po, kasi siya po ang nag-execute ng acknowledgement receipt po.
Ms. Acosta, ako po'y gusto ko pong maawa sa inyo kasi while you entrusted the entire amount of 125 million to Colonel Lachiga, who is not an accountable officer at all. I hope you realize, kayo po ang mananagot sa buong 125 million. Are you aware of that?
Yes, ma'am. Aware po ako.
Balikan ko po si Mary Grace Piatos. Anchoring my question on your statement na may mga Piatos sa Davao City. In spite of the pledge of 1 million by Young Guns, kung talaga pong may Mary Grace Piatos, I believe 2 weeks na ang nakaraan, but wala po kayang nagpapakilala na Mary Grace Piatos?
Piatos lang po ang sinabi ko, ma'am.
Ano po yun?
Piatos lang po na apelyido ang sinabi ko.
Yes, but you said that there are Piatoses in Davao City. May mga Piatos sa Davao. Kung hindi nyo man po talaga personally kilala that certain Mary Grace, bakit po kaya walang lumulutang? Kung talagang may Mary Grace Piatos, eh magkakaroon ho siya ng 1 million na walang kahirap-hirap. Would you agree with me if I would say the reason kung bakit walang lumulutang ay dahil wala naman talagang Mary Grace Piatos? Tama po ba?
Di po ako makasay ng yes or no, ma'am, kasi si Sir Lachica po ang nag-execute po, ang nagpapapirma po,
no,
ng acknowledgement.
Ms. Acosta, I'm not asking you about the personality of Mary Grace Piatos. This is a hypothetical question again. Having stated na may mga Piatos sa Davao and considering na nag-pledge ng Young Guns ng 1 million, tatanggapin ni Mary Grace Piatos. The only condition is magpakilala siya. Ako si Mary Grace Piatos. Tama po bang sabihin na kaya walang lumulutang na Mary Grace Piatos ay dahil ang totoo, wala naman talagang Mary Grace Piatos? Tama po o mali?
Yun po ang answer.
Tama
ko,
po o mali, Ms. Acosta?
Siguro, tama po yun, ma'am.
Okay. Now, let's proceed to that acknowledgement receipt with the name Cocoy Villamin. Sino po si Cocoy Villamin?
Ganun pa rin, ma'am. Di ko po siya kilala.
Secretariat, please flash again the AR.
Natanggap po lang kayo kay ano.
Mr. Chair.
Madam Vice President.
Thank you, sir. Ms. Acosta has been crying for the since this hearings started because of her fear and a lot of other things. Can we just give her some air?
1 minute suspensions declared. Congressman Margoleta, you recognize.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I know that our rules, procedure in aid of legislation includes supplementarily the use of the rules of court. Under the rules of court, Your Honor, which are the rules being used in the courts of law, hypothetical questions are not allowed to be asked. Are we supposed to insist on asking hypothetical questions?
Could you please be specific, Congressman Margoleta?
It's very specific, Mr. Chair. The witness is being asked hypothetical questions. This is allowed in the courts of law. If you're using the rules of court supplementarily, what is the purpose of asking hypothetical questions?
Under our internal rules, the rules of procedure governing the proceedings before the Committee on Good Government under Section 16, it provides that rules of procedure and evidence in any meeting of the committee, the rules of evidence prevailing in courts of law or equity shall not be controlling. And the committee shall use every and all reasonable means to ascertain the facts in each case speedily and objectively without regard to technicality of law or procedure.
Yes, Mr. Chair, we're talking of facts.
All in the intent.
We're not talking about hypothetical situations here. We're not supposed to be getting facts out of speculations. We cannot speculate on the questions that should be asked and answered. This will not benefit the committee, Mr. Chair. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Noted, Congressman Margolet.
Mr. Chair. Dagdag lang po na response, Mr. Chair, since always po ini-invoke na kung ano yung dapat na conduct ng committee, ano yung bounds ng mga discussions natin. Mr. Chair, again, ang ginagawa po natin ay in-aid legislation at hindi po tayo makakagawa ng mga batas, hindi natin maaral yung pwedeng maging mga batas kung hindi natin pag-uusapan yung mga posibleng scenarios kahit hindi pa nangyayari, Mr. Chair. We can't have good laws kung hindi natin pag-uusapan paano yan pwedeng ipatupad, paano yan pwedeng maabuso, which means yung nagiging line of questioning na ating colleagues are essential to the conduct of our proceedings sa committee. Ilang, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Mr. Chair, this is the problem of non-lawyers. They insist on something that should not be done.
Noted, Congressman Margoleta. Please continue, Congresswoman Luisto.
Ms. Acosta, ano po bang nararamdaman nyo? Of course, I'm concerned about you. Ano po yun?
Nanginginig po, ma'am.
Bakit po kayo nanginginig? Bukod po sa nanginginig, ano pong nararamdaman nyo? Hindi naman po ako sumisigaw.
Kasi po, wala po talaga akong alam kung sino po yun si Kukoy Villamin, si Grace Piatos po. Kasi po, si Sir La Chica po ang nasa ground po. Siya po ang nagpipipirma. Nag-base na lang po ako sa sinaol sa binalik niya sa akin na acknowledgement receipt po, ma'am.
Pero ma'am, I hope you acknowledge na yun pong sinasabi niyong ginawa ni Colonel La Chica. Yun po'y trabaho niyo as a special disbursing officer.
Yes, ma'am. Pero may utos po ang aking boss, ma'am, na i-release ko po kay Sir La Chica, ma'am.
I heard you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
We will just proceed with the question. Tell me, pag hindi nyo na po kaya, I will stop. Ano po? You just answer from what you believe is true to yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Punta po tayo kay Kukoy Villamin. Do you know this person?
Wala po talaga akong alam, ma'am.
Wala po kayong alam?
Yes po, ma'am.
Surname Villamin. May kilala po ba kay sa Davao na Villamin?
Wala po akong alam, ma'am. Wala po akong kilala, ma'am.
Okay. So you cannot answer with respect to the identity of this Kukoy Villamin. Mr. Chair, do we have the NBI here as well as the PSA? They are not yet here.
Not yet here.
But I believe that...
We have submitted the acknowledgement receipt. In process daw po.
Okay. Ms. Acosta, do you confirm that the 125 million for the last quarter of 2022 was utilized from December 21 to December 31 as is stated in the records?
Yes, ma'am. Based po sa binigay sa akin ni Sir La Chica,
okay,
na accomplishment report at saka acknowledgement receipt po.
Ms. Acosta, this is 125 million. Spent in, I believe, 10 days nga po ito eh. Hindi 11 days. Kasi under the law, when we count, we exclude the first, we include the last. So if we count from December 21 to December 31, this will be equivalent to 10 days. Tanggalin po natin yung sinasabi ni Chairman Acop na holiday. 3 days, in other words, 7 araw na lang po. Can you please enlighten us? Paano po kaya naubos, na ibayad, na disburse ni Colonel La Chica yung buong amount ng 125 million in 7 days?
Ma'am, hindi po ako makasagot niyan, ma'am, kasi hindi po ako ang naggastos. In reality po, ma'am, si Sir La Chica po ang may alam, ma'am.
Ma'am, you've been the, you were the Special Disbursing Officer of Davao from 2019 to 2022. And then you became the Disbursing Officer of the OVP. So kagaya po ng sabi niyo kanina, you have mastered already the process of utilization of confidential fund. Isang tanong lang po, posible po ba ito na ang 125 million ay magastos sa nalolooban lamang ng 7 weekdays?
Hindi ko po alam, ma'am, kasi hindi po ako ang personal gastos
Ms. Acosta,
po sa pera, ma'am.
The question is based on your experience as SDO. Sabi niyo po kanina, 3 years kayong naging SDO ng Confidential Fund in Davao City. You even said you have mastered already the process of utilization. Ayon po ba sa karanasan ninyong yun? Yun po bang 125 million? Kaya po bang gastusin yun sa loob ng 7 weekdays, araw na may pasok lamang? Base po sa inyong karanasan, kaya po o hindi?
Hindi ko yan masagot, ma'am. Kasi hindi po ako ang nag-disburse na 125 million, ma'am. Si Sir La Chica po, ma'am.
Ms. Acosta, our question is based on your experience.
Hindi po ganun ang confidential fund sa Davao, ma'am. Hindi po ganun kalaki, ma'am.
In other words, ayon po sa inyong karanasan bilang confidential fund ng Davao 2019 to 2022, hindi kaya gastusin ang 125 million in 7 days. Tama po ba?
Hindi po ako makasabing tama, ma'am, kasi hindi po ganyan ang confidential fund sa Davao, ma'am.
Ma'am, the question is based on your experience. Kung ito po ba'y dadalhin natin doon sa sitwasyon nyo bilang SDO ng Davao, kaya po kaya yun?
Hindi
gagastusin?
Hindi ko masagot, ma'am.
Okay. Now let us proceed to the certification. The Secretariat, please flash. May we know, Ms. Acosta, who prepared the certification? Secretary, please flash the document. May we know who prepared this certification, Ms. Acosta?
Ako po, ma'am.
Kayo po. You confirm the authorship of the signature above the name Gina F. Acosta sa inyo pong perma ito?
Yes po, ma'am.
Yes. And the document says, on the first paragraph, we certify that the amount of 125 million was incurred in connection with safe implementation of OVP initiatives and confidence building. Ms. Acosta, ano po ba yung confidence building?
Yan po yung isa po yun sa programa ng OVP na kung paano po ma-implement ang isang programa na maayos po at safety po.
Yun po ba ang ibig sabihin ng confidence building?
Yan po ang pagkaalam ko, ma'am.
Can you explain further? Pag sinabi po bang confidence building, ano po bang ibig sabihin nun? Is it synonymous to confidential activities? Pares po ba iyon?
Pwede po mag-ask ako sa aking lawyer, ma'am.
Yes po. Secretariat, can we provide a copy of the certification to Ms. Acosta? Okay.
1 minute suspension is declared by the chair. We excuse Gina Acosta para po ma-check po siya.
I understand, Mr. Chair.
Sa clinic. Yes.
Can I have few questions only for Mr. Ortonio?
Yes, please continue.
Mr. Ortonio, would you confirm kung may vault nga sa OVP, specifically in the extension office of Ms. Acosta?
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Mr. Chair,
yes, you are recognized, Mr. Ortonio.
Thank you, sir. Maybe before I answer the question of Honorable Luisro, would it be possible if I can provide an explanation first on my absence last week?
Mr. Chairman, yeah, it's all about
Congressman
supposedly
Paduan.
It's all about admin matters. So we'll discuss this later, especially Mr. Tenorio is under contempt. No?
Ortonio.
So Ortonio, I mean, yeah, he's under contempt.
Yes. Just answer the query
Chairman.
Of Congressman Luisro.
I cannot confirm, Honorable Luisro, if there is actually 3 vaults because it's only Ms. Gina Acosta who has knowledge on the vaults that are inside. The room that she mentioned earlier.
Are you saying that there are vaults, but you are not certain as to the number of them?
Yes, that's correct.
So you confirm that there are vaults, you are just not certain whether there are 3 or otherwise.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Would you know who, aside from Ms. Acosta, is aware about the vaults in her extension office?
As far as I know, Your Honor, it's only Ms. Acosta.
It's only Ms. Acosta. But how then did you get an idea that there are vaults, only that you're not certain about the number?
I knew about the vaults, Your Honor, because of the fact that she is the special disbursing officer and that there are funds that were going to be placed in the office.
Is
That's
it,
as far as I know.
Is it automatic that if the person is the SDO, she has to be in her custody vaults where she can secure the money?
Yes, that's my understanding po.
So, are you inclined to believe na ang mga SDO, normally, they're keeping vaults inside their office?
It can be keeping vaults, Your Honor, or cash, parang cash register, or a safe place where they can place their the money that they are entrusted to them.
Mr. Ortonio, since you were named by Ms. Acosta as the one who was with her during the time that she encashed the check, can you please walk us through? Paano po ba kayo nag-encash ng check eh? Let's start with paano ho nakapag-prepare ang Land Bank Show Boulevard that amount of 125 million, which I believe is beyond the normal cash that they're maintaining in their vault?
Based on the information that I know of, first is that the cash division informs Ms. Acosta that the check is already available and that it's ready for encashment.
Who heads the cash division?
At that time, it's Miss Carmelita Warren.
Carmelita Warren. Okay. Please proceed.
Yes. After the information to Miss Gina Acosta that there's already a check and ready for encashment, at that time, nung first time that she withdrew the money, she messaged me. She approached me and then asked if I can accompany her. And then,
how many times have you accompanied Ms. Acosta?
As far as I can remember, in all of the withdrawals that she have, the times that she withdrew money from the bank.
So since she is an SDO for confidential fund, you're referring to the withdrawals of confidential fund.
Yes, that's correct, Your Honor.
Would it be correct to say that for the OVP, apat na beses mo siya sinamahan? and that pertains to the 125 million of the last quarter of 2022, and then 125 million each for the three quarters of 2023.
Yes, that's correct, Your Honor, as far as I can remember.
And would you confirm kung itong apat na checking ito, lahat sa Land Bank Show Boulevard na in cash?
Yes, that's correct, Your Honor.
Okay, let's go back to December 20, 2022. Anong oras niyo po nakuha yung cheque sa cash division?
I do not know what time Ms. Gina was able to get the check from the cash division. It's Ms. Gina po who got the check from the cash division.
What time did you leave for Land Bank Show Boulevard?
If I can remember it right, during that occasion, we left the office in time that when we arrived at Land Bank, parang towards the end of the banking hours already. So maybe
so
around 3 o'clock.
3 o'clock.
Around 8, 3 o'clock.
3 o'clock. And how long did it take before the bank teller was able to encash the 125 million?
Based on my recollection, upon arrival at the bank, the money is already available, but it took a little bit of time just to count the money.
So can you please enlighten us? From 3 p.m., anong oras po kayo natapos?
More or less, siguro, Your Honor, maybe after 30 minutes. Maybe.
So 3:30. At 3:30, tama po ba sabihin yung pera nasa loob na ng apat na malalaking bag?
Yes, by that time.
3:30.
Yes, per my recollection, but I cannot be exact on the time.
Mr. Ortonio, I believe that may we know where the OVP's office is?
It's in Mandaluyong po.
Mandaluyong. How close is this to Show Boulevard?
Show Boulevard, Land Bank Show Boulevard to the office around 20 minutes.
So probably. 20 minutes?
Yes.
So tama yung sinasabi ni Ms. Acosta that around 4 p.m. they've arrived already at the office.
Office. That's correct.
And she placed all the money inside her extension office. Balikan po natin yun sa banko. There are contradictory statements po. Ang sabi po ni Ms. Acosta, tinulungan po sila ng mga security guard magkarga ng apat na bags sa inyong dalawang sasakyan. Which earlier, the bank manager and the security guard during that time denied. Ano pong totoo, Mr. Ortonio?
Based on my recollection, Your Honor, what I can remember is that Land Bank Show was able to provide a parang yung parang trolley, and then they helped us put it in the parang trolley and then wheel it out of the bank. That's what I can remember.
So there are three versions now. Ms. Acosta's version, tinulungan ng security guard magbuhat. The security guard's version, hindi tinulungan. And your version, you were provided with trolley.
That's what I can remember.
Assuming, Mr. Ortonio, that there is really a trolley, sino pong nagbuhat papunta sa trolley?
Again, as I can remember, it's coming from Land Bank po. That's what I can remember.
You are saying that there were people from Land Bank who helped you put all these bags on the trolley?
That's what I can remember.
And then what did they do with the trolley?
They wheeled it out of the bank and then helped in transferring to the vehicle.
Who actually placed the bags from the trolley to the vehicles?
Unfortunately, Your Honor, I could not remember. At the time that it was placed inside the car, I think I was still inside the bank. So I really
Why were you inside the bank?
At that time, Your Honor, if I can remember it right, I was having a little bit of conversation with Ms. Violi.
Who is Ms. Violi?
The Land Bank manager.
And will you be generous enough what you were conversing during that time that this have something to do with how you will carry the bag to the vehicle?
I cannot recall anymore the conversation that we've had.
Yes. How many bags were placed in the car where you seated?
All 4 bags were placed inside the car that I rode in.
Is that so?
Yes, that's correct.
That's another contradiction to the statement of Ms. Acosta.
Your Honor, if I may, if my memory serves me right, Ms. Gina wasn't able to mention where the bags were placed.
No. What she said, kung ma-hold up yung isa, may tira pang isa. Which leads me to one conclusion that the 4 bags were parted between the 2 vehicles. Otherwise, she will not be saying na may matitira pang isa kung sakaling ma-hold up yung isa. I'm just trying to manifest the contradiction in your statements.
Yes.
But I don't mind really if that's what you recall.
Yes. Respectfully, Your Honor, that's what I recall. And Ms. Gina wasn't really able to mention which vehicle the bags were placed.
And do you confirm her statement that you separated in 2 cars?
Yes, that's correct.
You seated in 1 car and you seated in the other car.
That's correct.
So would you confirm the statement of Ms. Acosta that she was instructed by the Vice President to give the 125 million to Colonel Lachica?
Unfortunately, Your Honor, I am not privy to that arrangement between Ms. Acosta and the Vice President.
One minute, Mr. Secretary.
Mr. Chair, Gina Acosta was rushed to the emergency room, so may I ask permission to join her, leave the hearing and assist my colleague in the office of the Vice President. Okay, I'll join you in the next hearing. Thank you.
Mr. Chair,
session resumes.
I believe that I have no more questions to raise at the moment, so I'm yielding to my fellow members of the committee.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair,
yes, DS JJ Suarez.
Point of clarification, and I'm unfortunately Ms. Gina Acosta is not here. There were some items where I'm trying to merge, and maybe Congresswoman Jinky can help me with this. Kanina po ba sinabi ni Ms. Gina Acosta may mga vault sa office of the Vice President? Can you confirm this, Mr. Antonio? Would you know of these vaults? Or Tonio?
I know of this vault, as mentioned earlier, Your Honor. Just with the fact or information that she is the special disbursing.
No, but have you seen these vaults?
Unfortunately, Your Honor, I haven't seen these vaults.
So who has seen these vaults?
I do not know who else has seen these vaults, but of course I assume it's Ms. Gina Acosta would have seen it, being
so,
the custodian.
So siya lang ang may alam ng vaults na yon.
I would assume, Your Honor.
No, because you are Assistant Chief of Staff,
Chief
correct?
Chief of Staff, correct.
So I'm sure you would know of vaults, because the vaults that she described were 4 feet high and 3, if I'm not mistaken. So you would know of this. I mean, it would be quite weird that an Assistant Chief of Staff wouldn't know of vaults in the office.
Yes.
So can you confirm these vaults, yes or no?
Yes, I confirm the vaults, and but I cannot confirm as to how many po.
Okay, so you've seen these vaults?
I have, as mentioned earlier, Your Honor, I haven't seen these.
So how can you confirm something that you have not seen?
Based on the information that was shared, to me po.
By whom? Yeah.
As mentioned po by Ms. Gina. And
so what you're saying is, previous to Ms. Gina saying that there were vaults, you didn't know that there were vaults?
I knew of vaults in the possession of Miss Gina, but again, Your Honor, I haven't seen these vaults before.
So, okay, because I'm trying to determine your knowledge of this vault. Because in our previous hearings, Ms. Sanchez, tinanong po namin kayo tungkol sa mga vaults. At ang sabi po ninyo, meron po kayong vault, kasi lang ang vault po ninyo ay para lang po sa payroll.
Petty cash.
And expenses, and petty cash expenses, correct? Attorney Sanchez?
Attorney Sanchez, you are recognized.
Yes, Mr. Chair, that is correct.
Yes. So I'm actually reading our transcripts here, no? So I'm aware of the vault as mentioned by the Director of Finance and Admin. It's used for, I think, payroll and other items.
And petty cash.
Yeah,
expenses,
and then when we continued on with the interpolation, Attorney Sanchez, you did not speak of any other vaults in the office of the Vice President.
That is correct, Mr. Chair, because
And we even asked you, when it came to the confidential funds, where were the funds kept? You said in an office.
Mr. Chair, I said that I have no personal knowledge. Yeah.
Okay, but in any case, so I'm just trying to put things together. So how many vaults are there in the office of the Vice President?
Mr. Chair, I'm only aware of one vault, which is used by the cash division.
And then Mr. Ortonio would attest that there are three other vaults other than the vault that Attorney Sanchez is speaking about.
Other vaults, Your Honor, for as mentioned by Ms. Gina Acosta.
Mr. Ortonio, walk me through here. You get the money from the banks.
That's correct, Your Honor.
And then the money is brought to where?
Brought to the office.
Brought to the office. Yes. And while in the office, where is the money placed?
Sorry, Your Honor?
While in the office, where is the money placed?
To be honest, Your Honor, I'm not familiar where Ms. Gina places it in the office. But yes, there is a room where Ms. Gina places the money.
Yes, I understand. But you have to understand, Mr. Ortonio, Ms. Gina Acosta has been excused because her blood pressure hit 150 over 100. And I'm sure in her state of health, she wouldn't be able to carry 125 million pesos by herself. Kayong dalawa, ang mga personalidad na may kinalaman sa pagdadala ng pera. So, ang sinasabi mo ba sa akin, nung dinala na ang pera sa OVP, sa Office of the Vice President, hindi mo na alam kung saan to idinala?
Yes, Your Honor. It's just Ms. Acosta together with
two other people.
Two VPSPG guards on duty at that day who helped Ms. Acosta
carry the bags.
To bring the money. Yes.
So, ang role mo hanggang sasakyan lang.
Yes, that's correct, Your Honor.
Okay. So, who are these two VPSG? Can you identify them, please?
I cannot remember anymore who those VPSPG on duty that day because they are on rotation.
Yes, but I'm sure you would know their names. I mean, you're talking about 125 million here, Mr. Ortonio. I mean, if it was just like a mere envelope that was submitted to the office, I would understand. But something so delicate as 125 million, siguro po, iilan lang ang pwedeng pagkatiwalaan ng halagang ito. At napakahirap naman pong paniwalaan na sasabihin mo sa akin, hindi ko maalala yung dalawang tao na yon. Sino po yung dalawang tao na yon, Mr. Ortonio?
Really, Your Honor, I could not remember because, again, the VPSPG that are on duty at the office regularly rotates po.
So are you trying to tell me, Mr. Ortonio, that this is the practice at the Office of the Vice President when you handle amounts amounting to 125 million pesos? Hindi nyo na po binibigyan ng masyadong pagpapahalaga at hindi nyo na po kinikilala yung mga taong dapat pagkatiwalaan upang siguraduhin na secure ang perang yon? Kasi kung hindi niyo po kilala, di parang nakakagulat po. Dahil malaking halaga po ito. At the very least, you should have certain protocols. I mean, from the delivery of the money to the office up to where it's being brought. I'm quite shocked, Mr. Ortonio, that you don't even know where the money is brought. Do you know where the money is brought?
As mentioned by Ms. Gina, it's brought to her extension office.
And the extension office is... This is where the vaults are, I presume.
Yes, I presume, Your
Honor. However, you have not seen these vaults?
No, Your Honor.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. I just wanted to get that clarified kasi medyo hindi lang po ako na... at saka dito lang sa Land Bank, can I just get back to you? Kasi medyo hindi po magtugma yung notes ko. Sabi po kasi ni Ms. Gina Acosta, may tumulong sa pagbubuhat. Sabi naman po ni Mr. Ortonio, inilagay po yung pera sa pushcart po ba? Anong sinabi ninyo? Ano pong ginamit? Trolley.
Parang trolley.
Trolley, oo. So, from the Land Bank, what is the procedure when it comes to cash withdrawals? Is the bank actually allowed to facilitate or aid clients when it comes to bringing out cash out of the banks?
Your Honor, as courtesy po to our clients, na-extend lang po namin yung help sa kanila.
Again?
As courtesy po to our clients, na-extend lang po namin yung help na yon sa client po.
So you confirm that the bags were trolleyed off out of the bank with the help of Land Bank personnel?
Actually, hindi ko na po maalala yung mga panahon na yan, Your Honor.
Okay. Dito sa dalawang security guard, kayo po ba yung on duty nung panahon na...
Ninyo.
Ha? Si Ninyo, Mr. Ninyo Bora, kayo po yung on duty nung nilalabas po yung pera?
Opo, sir.
Opo. Nung nilalabas po yung pera, kayo din po ang tumulong sa pagbubuhat at pagtutulak?
Hindi po.
Eh, sino pong tumulong?
Hindi ko po maalala kung sino yung tumulong.
Okay. Medyo hindi na tayo nagtutugma dito, ma'am. Kasi sabi nyo, as courtesy, tinulungan po sila. Kasi lang sinasabi po ng security personnel, hindi daw po. So, pwede po bang malaman natin kung ano po talaga ang nangyari?
Your Honor, yung pong pag-provide po siguro ng trolley, yun lang po yung extension ng pag-help namin. Pag-provide po ng trolley.
Ah, yung pag-provide ng trolleys. Ah, okay. Yes, so, Honor. Sino po ang nagtulak ng trolleys?
Hindi ko na po maalala, Your Honor.
Mr. Ortonio?
Based on my recollection, Your Honor, as far as I can remember, someone helped us and ang recollection ko po is it was from Land Bank. That's my recollection.
But Land Bank is saying they just provided the trolleys. The security officer said hindi daw po sila. Tapos ang sinasabi mo naman, taga Land Bank po ang tumulong. So, medyo hindi po nagtutugma yung statement nyo, Mr. Ortonio, sa statements po ng Land Bank. So, ano po ba talaga ang katotohanan?
Your Honor, that's what I can recall po as of this moment.
No, I'm not asking you of what you can remember as of this moment. What I'm asking you, Mr. Ortonio, is the truth and the fact. So, what is it?
Again, Your Honor, I'm relying on my memory right now, and that's what I can remember that happened that day.
In the four times that you withdrew money, siguro naman maaalala ninyo, apat na beses, 125 million, 500 million pesos ang pinag-uusapan natin. Siguro naman malalagyan nyo ng konting pagpapahalaga, maalala nyo man lang kung sino ba ang tumulong sa inyo kasi dadalawa lang po kayo. Sabi niyo ikaw at saka si Miss Gina Acosta. So, ang tanong po, sino po ang kasama pa po?